Start that up. Welcome in, Phantom. Uh-oh.
What up, streamer? How goes it?
There you go. What's up with you, man? I saw Baker and Chad, Bones, Swook. I'm sorry, Phantom. Did you mention something? I don't know if you mentioned something.
No, just saying I'm good, and it's Friday.
Oh, yeah? Heck yeah. End of the week for some of us. Hopefully you finish strong and you're able to relax your weekend. Like I said, Skunk, I see. What's up? Swook. Bones. Bones is joining us right away today. Hopefully everyone's doing all right so far. Had a morning, afternoon, evening, or night. I'm still having a terrible day, Swook. I hope it goes better, though. At least I hope it gets better. It is Friday, so that they can't take that away from you. Once you finish the day, you're good for the weekend. So I always try to see it that way. You going out for curry? Ooh. Curry's been always been very spicy for me, but
that sounds good.
Never a bad thing. So today, slow it down a little bit. I'm gonna play one of these adventure games. I heard it was really good. It was a PC port to the 3DO, where the biggest change from the PC is that it's fully voice acted on 3DO.
Ooh, interesting.
So I want to see. I want to see how it is. I've been on an adventure games kind of kick. Point and click. So this is one of the older ones. So we'll see how it plays. What's up, Chud? Oh, Indian curry, he says. Normal chicken curry is homemade. Nice. Hopefully it's very, very good for you. Yeah, welcome in, Chud. Khaled, what's up also? Oh, we're getting all the heavy hitters today. Hopefully you guys are
all. Yeah, no kidding. Getting all the band back together.
Everyone getting the band. Where's the Blues Brothers? So, like I said, it's called The Lost Files of Sherlock Holmes. It's a 3DO game. It's one of the few 3DO games I actually do own. It does not have the long box cover, but it is the CD cover. I am playing on a 3DO, so it's a completely legit. I am going to restart it because the intro just runs through it and it goes right into the game. There is no like stop and attract mode. Pretty weird. There you go, Bones. You got it, man. You got it. I know
that's
who
funny.
I know who the expert in the room is now, for sure. So this is Electronic Arts, when they used to not just do sports games and, you know, do the same game over and over every year. Check something else. Let's see. No, okay, we're good. The Lost Files of Sherlock Holmes. 1994. If Pia was here, she would say it was a good year.
That she would.
The alley behind the Regency Theater. I think now game capture is cheap. Look at that shady character. Oh, wow, the animation's really good. Is he waiting for somebody? You were 14 when this game was released. 94, yeah, so was I. Oh. With a very small knife. Here comes fire.
Yep, right on time.
Early the following morning on Baker Street. Oh, Baker. Yeah, I love the animation. It's cool. Rippers again. An old-timey cop. Youngins, all of you. Welcome, yeah. Empire. We're youngins?
Begging
wow.
Your pardon, ma'am. This is a note for Mr. Holmes from Inspector Lestrade of Scotland Yard.
Oh, very well. I'll see that he gets it. Thank you, Constable.
Let me know if you guys can hear it fine or if it's too loud.
Have you been sufficiently fortified by Mrs. Hudson's murderous coffee, Watson? Put your mind to this mystery. Whatever are you on about home so early in the morning? Sorry to interrupt your reading, old man. Mrs. Hudson just delivered a very intriguing note. Would you care to peruse it?
Peruse it?
By all means. Mr. Holmes. A young woman has been brutally murdered outside the Regency Theatre in Oxford Street. The evidence here suggests that Jack the Ripper...
Yep, there it is, Biggsy, you called it.
Yep, fantastic year.
Fantastic year.
Despite your contention that the Ripper's work is without motive, and
to the storyline while this guy is swinging his hips. I know, can't hear the narrator over the dancing saxophone guy. Oh, we finished the game.
Oh, hey, there it is.
Speed run.
World record, right here.
Fluffy unicorns dancing on rainbows. Fluffy unicorns dancing on rainbows.
Someone died. Let's investigate. The end. Dancing with rainbows. Pink fluffy unicorns they are. I didn't even die this time. That's just getting game over automatically.
Yeah, game over. Game over, man. Game over.
Game over.
Well, excuse me, princess.
Granny, what's up?
Yeah, happy Friday indeed.
Got an appointment at 1, so just a quick hi and happy Friday. All right, no problem. Thank you, Granny, for jumping in, saying hi. Hopefully, your appointment goes well. Queen, if I may, Queen. Well, excuse me, Miss Queen.
You still got to get that soundbite.
Of what? The excuse me?
Yeah.
I have it.
Oh, you do?
Yeah.
When'd you put it in?
I put it in yesterday. That's why when I kept trying to test the sound.
Ah, okay.
That was an excuse. Just type What's in excuse.
Okay.
Well, excuse me, princess.
Nice. I love it.
Isn't that awesome? There was
such a great sound bite.
There was like a 10-minute video of all the times he said excuse me throughout the series. It's not a very long series. I think it's only like 12 episodes. But it's all the times he says it. And I had to find the perfect one where you could hear his voice with no music or sound effects. It was tough. I'm still hugging from yesterday. It's nice, but it's a problem. What's so? Oh, wait, you're hugging. Whoa, whoa. The command created a loop. Like, what? Whoa, whoa, whoa. Explain. Created a loop. The command created a loop. A hug, Homa. I did the group hug and it never stopped. Really? So let me try that. Group hug. I mean, it looks fine. And even on my chat, it seemed okay. Or am I missing something?
Yeah, I don't get it.
I think I'm missing something. I don't know what it is. You'll never stop hugging now. Oh, okay. Never. What's up, Ronan? Welcome in. Imagine playing this without cosplay and a pipe and a hat. Pro streamer. You know what? That would have been a great idea. Oh, that's a good idea. Bones hates hugs. That's all right, Bones. You got how about a stern handshake? Granny has a hug coma. All right, so what are we doing here? Okay, so I can move around, and then when I click on something, I can look at it, move to it, talk to it. No. What does that say? Gas? Use? No. Give? No. Okay. So I can't do anything with that. Lab table. Let's go to the lab table. Let's take a look at it. Move to it. This pine-topped, acid-stained table holds a variety of laboratory apparatuses, ready to perform chemical analysis and experiments. A vast collection of chemicals tests. All right. Oh, okay. So you just push the B button. Okay, pushing the B button automatically looks at stuff. Or yeah, the C button moves me. Oh, okay. So the A button. If I click on something, right? Say, like we said, we're on look. Right? Now, if I push the B button over something, he'll look at it and give me a description. Bugs make me fart. Yeah, Ronan, this is a old school point and click. Could you lower the music? It's quite loud. I don't know if I can. Let me see. Let's go to setup. Let's go to setup. Ah, you can. How does that sound? Video speech. I want to turn
Come
to
along, Watson. The game's afoot.
I want to turn to speech.
Come along, Watson. The game's
every,
afoot.
All the way up. Alright, we're turning videos on. Much better. He's not holding his jacket open. He's holding, like, the lining of the jacket. I think, at least. Okay. Got it. No! This is a historically accurate game. Alright, made of... Okay, so he just looks around. Okay. So I know we gotta go somewhere. Let's see what Watson says. I think there's supposed to be real-time videos in this also, where, like, no actors are playing. Okay, so two questions. Have you decided to wear your bowler hat for this investigation, Watson? Have you already begun your journal entries, Doctor?
Have you decided to wear your bowler hat for this investigation, Watson?
As always, Holmes, I feel positively undressed without it.
Okay! Did you guys hear that just fine? What's up, what's up? Mr. Gohan? Bio?
Hey, what's going on?
Negative Eagles and Snips. Wow! Wow, running. It's kind of cool, isn't it, how they put in the real actors with the cartoon. Let's get some British accent. I don't want it. I don't want it. How is it? Insult anyone, because I will. Nothing of interest here. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. I am sorry. So what's in my inventory? I have the message requesting help and a number of business cards. So we can look at the request, the help.
Still shooting! I'm still getting headshots! It's like boom, headshot! Boom, headshot! Boom, headshot!
The Poro? Poro? So we gotta go to... Jeff's work. Where was the place again? The outside the Regency Theater in Oxford Street. So we're going to Oxford Street, Regency Theater. Okay, got it. Richie Migley, bro. All right, let's move. We're gonna go ahead and go to the door. This cannot be moved. Okay. Does he just use it?
Come along, Watson. The game's afoot.
Quite so, Holmes.
Quite so, Holmes.
God, these actors are great.
There was a Sherlock Holmes game on the Sega CD. There's two of them, actually, where you go around towns and you gotta solve the mysteries and all that. But it's not like this. It's more like Myst, where it's just pictures. And a couple of videos here and there, but... Oh, okay. Okay, let's see what two questions. Are the rest of your lads available, Wiggins? I will be requiring your assistance, Wiggins. What do we go with? Let's require... Music's still very loud? Okay, let me, I'll bring it down some more. It seems like whenever they start talking, they, I lowered the in-game volume also. It seems like whenever they start talking, though, that the music does lower. I could lower it some more, though. That's fine. How's that sound? I do like it when the music is kind of more of a backdrop. Especially in something like this. Let me know what that sounds like. Okay, so we're gonna talk to dear old Wiggins. Oh, well, when I talk, it doesn't... Oh, okay, I got it. Is that better? Hopefully that's better. You don't want to hear my terrible British accent, believe me. Here, here, Wiggins.
I will be requiring your assistance, Wiggins.
At your service, Mr. Holmes. You got a job for the irregulars?
Well, no, Wiggins, not just at the moment.
Very good, sir. Let me know when there's anything I can do for you. We can all use the brass.
Oh, okay, so I could ask both questions.
Are the rest of your lads available, Wiggins?
They's at the ready, sir. Tell me what you need and I'll pass it on. The Zaydu's willing to work, so it'll cost 8 bob a day, plus the usual reward.
8 bob? I take it it's the money. What's 8 bob? $8? Shut up, Robin. That's messed. Stop it. Stop. Stop.
My compliments, Mr. Rigby. The day finds you well, I trust.
Oh, indeed, Mr. Holmes. Business has been brisk. The great British public devours anything to do with the Ripper. While Jack's at work, my family is eating steak and kidney pud.
Yeah, so that's definitely some British slang. So a bob is a shilling, which in that time was 1/10 of a pound.
So like 10 cents?
Yeah, sort of. So yeah, basically 80 cents a day plus reward.
Challenging case, is it not, Watson?
Oh, quite enough to tangle my senses, Holmes. I hardly know which way to turn.
I like how you get the different choices. But they'll act it out.
These hideous Ripper crimes have exhausted the resources and imagination of Scotland Yard, Watson. Can we do better with our case?
No, have you in the lead, Holmes? I'm sure we shall.
Okay, now that that's out the way, how do we go... How do we go somewhere? Let's see. How do I not stay here? Oh, you absolutely can, Ronan.
Are the rest of your lads available, Wiggins?
They's at the ready, sir. Tell me
Days
what
at the ready.
The Zaydu's willing to work, so it'll cost 8 bob a day, plus the usual reward.
Okay, so nothing's different there. Sherlock Miggs, nothing will be solved ever.
Hello again, Mr. Rigby. Still well,
I'll just be lost all the time.
Can't complain, Mr. Holmes. And if I did, who would listen?
Too true. There's so little kindness in the world. Good day to you.
Oh, he answered differently. Okay. So maybe I gotta keep asking the same thing?
Hello again, Mr. Rigby. Still well, I trust.
Can't complain, Mr. Holmes. No. And if I did, who would listen?
Too true. There's so little kindness in the world. Good day to you.
Everyone's so polite.
I will be requiring your assistance, Wiggins.
Yeah.
At your service, Mr. Holmes. You got a job for the irregulars?
Well, no, Wiggins. Not just at the moment.
Very good, sir. Let me know when there's anything I can do for you. We can all use the brass.
You can use the brass. I take it that's, money? Currency? All right, let's see. Clothes, Save, set up, use, give, look, move around, talk. Let's move around. It's an exit. Oh, okay. Okay, okay, I just needed to go to the end of the area here. Ooh, here we go. An alley. Is that already the spot that we need to go? Oh, yeah. It's got the theater face to it. Whoa! Only the threatened Wiggins with violence could smack us. We'll settle him.
Mr. Holmes, Dr. Watson, very good of you to come so quickly. After you've thoroughly examined the scene and the corpus delicti, please share your observations with me.
Oh, it was a poor lady. They just left her there. The corpse. Let's go look at the corpse. So a woman, approximately 25 years old, has had her jugular vein viciously slashed. This is certainly the cause of death. So there are several non-fatal gashes on her abdomen, abrasions in the back of her neck, and scratches on her left ring finger. The distinct odor of a particularly alloying and inexpensive brand of perfume pervades the body. Yeah, I know, that's fucking graphic. Okay. Oh, we can check the abrasions. The abrasions on her neck imply that her attacker forcibly removed some sort of heavy chain on her necklace. Or necklace. There are three separate lines where a chain scraped her neck, all of which are deep and vivid. Oh, cat! Ooh, knife wounds. Let's see what the knife wounds say. The wounds were clearly made with a short blade, perhaps the size and shape of a scalpel. Damn, he could tell all that? Close observation reveals that the blade was serrated. There's a trace of a white, powdery residue of unknown nature on the victim's coat immediately beside what appears to be the first of the abdominal wounds. Ooh.
You can do it!
It's stupid. I read it in head. Well, I do say, she did. That's hilarious. Okay, so we already read that part. These are the abrasions. The corpse is the same. Okay, so we already know that part. We got the knife wound, which was the scalpel. The white powdery residue. We'll pause this for a second. Is there a pause button? I think you just leave it there. We'll run that Stream Raiders real quick, guys. And of course, it has an update. Of course. You're stupid, Ronan. That's fucking hilarious. Can you store stuff in the... Oh, come on. Come on, skunk. And I thought it smelled bad on the outside. Two people? Come on, guys. You can pause that. No, I guess you're right. Yeah, that doesn't look good, Chud, for sure. Especially since my main character is a fucking healer. I don't even have an attack. Oh, this is bad. Oh, it's bad. And there goes that. Oh, good, we had a flying rogue, and they just sat there and did nothing. That's excellent. We'll try to keep playing. Let's see if we can get more people in. Start battle. Oh, Okay, what was the other thing I needed to put down? It was the healers and rogues. Okay, I need to put healers and rogues. So what we'll do is I'll put a rogue down. Maybe that'll help the proceedings. Wait, what was the other one? There was another one. One second here. The power of friendship, place three, set battle plans in five battles. Oh, okay, let me set battle plans. Battle planning. We're just gonna vibe. Just vibe. Right there, guys, that's all. That's all we gotta do. Back to the game. So, that's good. Welcome. It's Paya. Of course, Paya made your day better. All right, let's check out this the white powdery residue. It's Coke. The substance was most probably on the murder weapon at the time of the attack. A thorough chemical analysis would most likely reveal its composition. Oh, don't we have the that chemical set at the house? Can I pick that up? I can. Okay. Let's get us a sample. Nice. That helps a lot. We already checked out the corpse itself. I don't think we can check anything else out. Let's open the wound. Okay, so knife wounds, corpse, abrasions. Okay, let's talk to our guy, see if we got anything else of interest.
Is there anything you can tell me that isn't obvious from the scene, Inspector?
The deceased was an actress here at the theater, name of Sarah Carraway. She lived by herself out in Bayswater. According to her only witness, there's a sister, whereabouts presently unknown. The witness found the body, but remembers nothing of the person she saw fleeing the scene. You may talk to her if you like, though she's a bit in the way of being hysterical at the moment. She's in the victim's dressing room, through that door and up the stairs. But before you go, I'd like you to confirm some theories of my own.
I'd like you to confirm some theories of my own. Okay. Let's talk to him again.
Have you already decided on an explanation for the crime, Inspector?
No, this is on the 3DO.
There is no doubt that this is the Ripper's doing.
One second, I'll explain it in just a second.
Miles away from his habitual haunts in Whitechapel is of absolutely no significance. If he'd left his calling card, it would be no clearer. The man is a monster.
So he's saying it's Jack the Ripper right away, but he's not leaving a calling card? No, they're probably not wearing gloves. Busta, this is it's a PC game, right? That I think the PC game comes in two different chapters, right? It's two different games you could buy. But it was ported to the 3DO as one full game, which contains both chapters. That's what we're playing right now. What's cool though is the 3DO version added the voice acting and I think the videos also, which would make sense. But it added the voice acting. So oh, that's cool, Spook. That's an awesome story. That's very nice. Quiet, it's not your style. Yeah, that's how he runs it. I think, I'm not sure. I would assume that FMV is with the 3DO only because, I mean, if you're gonna add the voice acting, I'm pretty positive the voice acting is added to this. What's up, Doc Sticks? Welcome in. Appreciate the follow. Big Nard. Oh, this is a Six Figure Gaming. I want to say that's him. What, do you got multiple accounts and you're following me with each one? That's I appreciate that. That's a way to do it.
Oh, hopefully that is who it is and not a follow bot.
Yeah, I hope so. We'll see how it goes. So I hope that explains Busta about the game. I had to look it up to confirm all of it, but I'm pretty sure that's how it worked. So, but I like it so far. I like the style.
I'm afraid I cannot give myself the pleasure of agreeing with you, Inspector. And being a man of scientific temperament, I doubt whether Dr. Watson would concur with your theory.
Oh, he's saying he's not the
Without
Ripper.
Hearing the results of the medical examiner's investigation, I would not even presume to have a theory.
Quite right, Doctor. Mr. Holmes and I perhaps overstep ourselves, though I am certain that the official inquest will prove me correct.
All right, so the other investigator thinks it's Jack the Ripper, but it doesn't have any of the, I guess, his markings to it. Where Sherlock Holmes is more like, let's not go right to that conclusion.
You seem very sure of your facts, Lestrade, but I believe that there is evidence that contradicts your interpretation.
I assure you that I have examined everything in great detail, Mr. Holmes. I seriously doubt that I have missed a significant clue. What have you seen that goes against my theory?
Oh, they're talking shit to each other now. In British. Which means it sounds very cordial. If your info is false, there would be trouble. Yeah, I could be Jack the Ripper.
I suspect that you noticed that the victim's jewelry is missing. What do you make of that?
I presume you are referring to the abrasions on her neck and hand. As you well know, the Ripper takes selected items of jewelry from his victims. This further supports my case, Holmes. I believe that if my theory were flawed, you would be the man to set me straight. But it looks like you have nothing material to add.
Wow, he's talking shit. What do you make of that? It's missing. I don't know. It's missing, sir. Well, because that's what he's saying. Like, I guess, like the other guy explained, Jack the Ripper takes tokens of his victims. You tell him, Watson. It's not official shit talking until they smack each other with dueling gloves. That's what he's getting rid of. Well, they're not wearing any gloves, like you mentioned earlier. That guy just running through the crime scene and going digging through that woman, picking shit up with bare hands.
The killer's choice of weapon is most telling, don't you think?
Indeed. My professional eye tells me that this woman was killed with a surgeon's scalpel, and we know the Ripper uses a scalpel with the skill of a medical man. Isn't that so, Dr. Watson?
Trying to turn Watson against us.
I've read, Inspector, the answer is yes. But I would not presume to commit myself before the autopsy is completed. I must say that if a scalpel was used, it was a dull one. The wounds appear a bit ragged.
But it did say it was serrated.
Well, that's as may be. I'm certain that the medical examiner will confirm observation that the scalpel was the instrument of death. Mr. Holmes, do you have any credible reason to believe that the weapon was not a scalpel?
Also highly ineffective, being a detective like a fucking man, barehanded. I'm telling you. Yeah, exactly. Also, so I have three options to work with. If you look closely at the victim's coat and the wounds, because the murder weapon is missing, to think the Ripper is a medical man is ridiculous on its face. No doctor would engage in such fiendish behavior. He did say something about a serrated edge. They had shaky hands.
If you look closely at the victim's coat and at the wounds, you may notice that the fatal blade had a serrated edge.
Dr. Watson, can one find a serrated scalpel in a physician's black bag?
I regret, Inspector, that I know of no such instrument in the hands of any medical man.
That is unusual. But I suspect that it is insignificant. I never said the Ripper was a doctor. Perhaps his other scalpel lost its razor edge. He's done enough foul work with it, heaven knows. Let's not confuse the investigation with trivialities, gentlemen.
Huh, okay. It was not a surgical killing. Oh my god, Busta. Sticks! That was sticks this time.
Perhaps the murderer was imitating the style of Jack the Ripper. The gutter press has been filled with lurid accounts of the fiend's disgusting exploits.
Perhaps won't feed the bulldog, Doctor. I need facts. Mr. Holmes, my hypothesis is that the Ripper is responsible for this brutal murder. Because there may be a bit of confusion surrounding the serrated blade, I will concentrate my efforts on the question of the murder weapon. But I would not be averse to you and Dr. Watson looking further into this entire matter, if you wish. You may speak with the witness in the victim's dressing room, and you may want to examine the victim's flat at 21 Creed Street.
They call it flat, so a flat is an apartment? I assume that's what that is. The case of the serrated blade. Yeah. See, I was telling you, Six, I started getting into this adventure style, the old adventure PC games. I think they're really cool.
Is there anything more you can tell me, Inspector?
Got it.
I have said all I have to say. I can only hope that my inquiries into the source of the murder weapon will reveal some new link that will lead me to this foul criminal and help me send him to the gallows. I hope you've seen something that I've overlooked, though I suspect the chance is remote. It appears I have little choice save to report to the Yard that Jack the Ripper is no longer satisfied with hunting in Whitechapel. A citywide alert must be posted.
Oh, so Jack the Ripper only killed in a certain area. He says Whitechapel. And I guess since it's beyond that scope. Want some rye? Of course you do. Yeah, these are really interesting, Bus. I agree. Once I started playing a few of them, I started having fun with them. I think they're so cool. Full Throttle was my shit. That was the first game that I played back in the day on DOS that really introduced me to this genre, like really full blown. And I thought it was so cool ever since. I could not remember the name of the game until more recently, though, when they had announced that remake. I could not remember the name of that game. I remember seeing it. A friend of mine had it on his PC, and he showed it to me, and I just was blown away by it. Brindlewood Bay, but that's a PC only? Oh, okay. Oh, those... Quiet, Paya. All right, so we're talking to the cop now. Is everything here exactly as you found it? Do you have any information that would assist our investigation? Let's make sure everything's exactly the way it was.
Is everything here exactly as you found it?
Nothing's been moved since I arrived, Mr. Holmes.
That's a manly stash.
The inspector, and he was most particular in his instructions. Touch nothing, he says. So I've been standing here like a lump.
Oh, do you have any information? Good.
Do you have any information that would assist our investigation, Constable?
No, Mr. Holmes.
Some days you just can't get rid of a bomb.
The newspaper journals and half the nosy buggers in London, I've been preoccupied, as you might say.
All right, so he doesn't have anything new or anything extra to add to it. So can we look at anything else in the scene? They did say that there's the lady who found the body. is in the back, traumatized by the whole thing. Ooh, it's a hat. There's a hat right here. The Telltale games are awesome too. And I would say it's a good, evolution of this type of games. But you know how me, you know how I am. Like, I like my retro stuff. Sound like he's in boogers. It's Carmen Sandiego's hat. Yeah, look at it. He killed Carmen Sandiego. A lady's very stylish hat, fashioned in fine crimson silk. Can I pick that up? Oh, we took it.
Please look at anything you like, but I shall need that hat as evidence.
Okay, so he won't let me pick it up. He got all angry with me because, ooh, the handbag. We didn't see the handbag. The Ripper found Carmen. She ain't going nowhere now. It's a single silk line handbag. Sometimes. Big dog. Six, that's you, and I know that is you. Why are you on different accounts doing the same rewards? Sometimes called a reticule. So the contents: a pocket mirror, a tin of facial powder, a large metal key, a kerchief. They didn't say handkerchief, just a kerchief, and some cashews have been dumped out and apparently subjected to a hasty search. Somebody looked at it first.
Please examine anything you like, but I shall need that hat bag and its contents as evidence.
Yes, she does. Okay, so can I open it? Alright, that was look. We're gonna open. Cannot be open. Okay, that's fine. What's this down here? Cigarette butts. Ooh, what is this? Behind one corner of the crate are a half dozen cigarette ends, recently crushed into the dirt. The brand is common and smoked by thousands of Londoners. The smoker was a man wearing heavy shoes or work boots, given the length of the butts. His fingers are most certainly stained by nicotine. Interesting. Oh, he doesn't know about the cigarettes. The cigarette butts. Oh. You're right, Busta. Evidence tampering. Uh-oh, it was murder. I mean, a good swoop. Yeah, those were not by swoop this time. Those are by Styx, our other very mischievous follower here. Styx, I've known him forever, and he can be mischievous. Let's see what these barrels look like. There's a storage area for damage or discarded stage props from this season's plays. So these items are waiting for the dustman. The entire area appears undisturbed. I can be kerchief. Let's see. Nothing of interest. Is there anything else? Iron bar. Ooh. Oh, it's broken. From the side here. This is a 2-foot section of iron pipe. Both ends are corroded by rust. There is a trace of red paint on one end. Ooh, okay. I can take that. It's not part of the investigation. This guy's not, he's not picking up everything. So it looks like he could either be part of the railing that's coming out the door, or it could be from that top ladder that's right above us. It appears to be a common theater pay bill. Maybe there's fingerprints or something on it we can use. We'll take that also. Lurk seeing a bid buddy gonna work, leaving the streams up. Appreciate that, Styx. You don't have to go all out with that with all the three, but certainly is appreciated. Hopefully, everything goes fine with you. You enjoy your day, bro. Thank you again. All right, so let's go talk to the lady inside. There she is.
You must be Mr. Holmes and Dr. Watson. I'm Henry Carruthers, a stage manager. Inspector Lestrade told me you might want to look about the place. Well, feel free. I'm afraid we can't be of much help. Poor Sarah.
Is that the girl who witnessed the incident?
Yes. Her name is Sheila Parker.
Comfort foods.
She was
there you
in
go.
Dreadful state earlier. Fainted dead away, as you can see. She...
Still whoa, relax,
upset.
Ronan, relax.
I
come on.
Be able to answer
come on.
Questions just yet.
Be nice. Sheila Parker. Miss Parker, I'm sorry to trouble you. Do you think you could bring yourself to describe what you saw? You traitor. I'm not a traitor. I just...
Miss Parker,
like the
I'm sorry to trouble you. Do you think you could bring yourself to describe what you saw?
I saw Sarah lying there. Oh, it's so horrible. I can't bear to think about it.
Oh, the overacting is great.
She seems near hysterical, Holmes, and rightly so. I doubt she'll be of much help in her current condition.
That's what sells how British they are. With the sideburns? Basically the cheater though. Relax, Paya. Relax. Oh, did you guys see that? Oh, speaking of cheating. Ronan, I put up on my Discord. We did a run yesterday of Legend of Zelda. And I put up the clip of me doing that glitch where you can beat the game in just under a couple of minutes. Or, yeah. I guess you can consider beating. Because you do this glitch, and then you can automatically go right to the ending. So these things. Glitch cheater, yeah. Same difference. Boxport portraits of several notable London stage actors of the previous generation are glued securely on the wall. World record, I'm subbing. Shit. No, I'm not running world record stuff. I do want to do some cool glitches though. Like while I'm playing a game, kind of like we did with the Zelda thing, where I'll run some glitches and maybe just clip out the glitch parts as I do them. So I thought that was kind of neat. So the chair, a straight back velveteen upholstered chair, probably intended for visitors. It's a bit worn and has seen better days, but the upholstery is not ripped, nor do any of the finishing tracks appear loose. So, perfectly upholstered chair. Let's see what the flowers are. So these are pink carnations with dark red veins on the pedestals. They're startling, but common effect is probably achieved by standing the flowers in some kind of dye or staining fluid. An analysis of one of these blooms might prove useful. Oh, guess we're picking up some flowers, baby. There we go. Oh, what do you spy? The chest is closed and locked. There are scratches in the wood around the lock. Deep enough to suggest that it has been forced open more than once. Ooh. No, there's not, Busta. It's been, let's check our inventory. Is there anything I could use? Number of business cards, pottery specimen, Cigarette butts, iron bar. Let's beat it with the iron bar. Bill, a flower. Okay. There's nothing to, Maybe we'll give her a flower? You think that'll work? Maybe it'll make her feel better? Let's go give. Give. Flower. And we'll give it to the lady. Give flower to Sheila Parker. No, thank you. Okay, never mind. She don't want shit. She's gonna sit there and just cry. Alright, fine. Let's check out wardrobe. The cigarette butts are gonna be very useful, yes. Especially when we take it back to our chemical lab we have at home. Yeah, maybe that'll calm her down. Actually, I'll do that too. Oh, we opened up wardrobe. What do we have in here? Oh, we closed it. No, look. Open. And then look into it. All right. The shelves have been ripped out and it contains costumes used by the theater company. The sleeves and pockets of several garments are turned inside out. And the overall condition of the clothing suggests that it was poorly maintained or that it has been ransacked. Maybe they were looking for something? They were looking for something, so they checked all the costumes because all the pockets are out, and which would explain the chest here, the drawer being that the lock was pried open and everything was scratched. Look at that. I can be a detective. I'm a detective. Dressing screen. Let's see, a well-traveled but unexpectedly lovely oriental silk dressing screen. The demands of modesty forbid an explanation of what goes on behind the screen, but suffice to say, there is nothing worthy of note here now. All right, that's just a dressing thing. Let's see what Henry Caruthers, if he's got anything else to say to us. So the stage manager seems more impatient than distressed. He's fiddling with the door latch incessantly, but does nothing constructive. On his belt hangs a key. Ooh, can we get that key? Pick up. Let's see if we can just take his key. We're gonna use, was it like in Skyrim? Where you just sneak up on somebody and steal their key? Nothing of interest here. There's something shiny in this room. Wait, the perfume bottle. Remember he said the lady had a perfume? A very specific type of perfume. The perfume is called Eau de Seine? 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 I don't know. The label lists the address of the perfumery as Bell's Perfumery. Am I saying that right? In Westminster. There is a ribbon around the bottle as if were a gift. I see the thing. Okay, something shiny you said. Let's see if we can pick that up. Alright. I don't know what you're talking about, something shiny. What could be shiny? Give me a clue. Is it in the left side of the room or right side? Ooh, the mirror. Okay, let's see what the mirror is. The mirror is on one solid piece of glass with no removable back. The nooks and crannies of the carved mirror frame, which is poorly painted on a dingy yellow to look like gold, revealed nothing out of the ordinary. It's on the right side, you say. What's the spring underneath the wardrobe? There's a steel spring attached to a small square mass of solid brass. We took it. Oh, okay. Dude, I don't know how you saw that shit. Now I'm looking at it like in a big screen. Holy crap. Ronan, you are the superior detective.
Miss Parker, I'm sorry to trouble you. Do you think you could bring yourself to describe what you saw?
I saw Sarah lying there. Oh, it's so horrible. I can't bear to think about it.
Yeah, she's no use to us.
She seems near hysterical, Holmes, and rightly so. I doubt she'll be of much help in her current condition.
I like how they even green screen like the room that they're in for the voice, the FMV parts. That's kind of cool. Oh wow, we can talk to Watson like crazy. Dell, what's up? We're gonna run that stream raiders real quick, guys. Guys, thank you for helping me on that. Stream Raiders, that first one was pretty bad, and we end this one, we just manhandle. Very nice. Chud and Skunk, congrats guys, you got the rewards for that battle. Thank you for the help, well-deserved rewards. All right, on to the next one. This is a two skull, shouldn't be too difficult either. Where is my... Was it healer I gotta do? One second here. Three healers and three rogues. Yeah. So I'll just switch off between the two. I'll put another healer down. And then we'll set up battle planning and just vibe it. Everyone just vibe right there. That's all you need to do. Just chill. Enjoy yourselves. Ready for battle. Back to the game. What's up, Dell? Welcome in. We are playing a Sherlock Holmes game on a 3DO. It's called The Lost Files of Sherlock Holmes. It's like a... It's a PC port. It's supposedly added video and audio. Voice acting. Which has been very cool. So right now we're trying to figure out who killed this woman. No problem, Baker. What's up? So this woman's distress appears to be genuine. Watson is a professional. You were saying something, Phantom?
She's been working, so of course she, you know, sits here quietly.
Of course.
Then again, so have I, because, you know, people just won't leave me the hell alone. Don't they know I'm busy?
You gotta do what you gotta do. He's like, I gotta solve the case. What's his
name? Besides, we already know that Jack the Ripper did it. You just gotta find out who Jack the Ripper is.
This woman's I think it might be somebody genuine, Watson.
As a professional observer,
or at least Sherlock Holmes seems like he's hinting it might be terrible shock. Mimicking.
Oh, it's Jake the Ripper.
Jake. Jake from State Farm.
Jake from State Farm. Offended,
the woman is an actress, and you yourself, Holmes, have fooled me countless times with your own sham performances.
Oh, he's saying that she could be performing, that she's hysterical, but that she's an actress. She could be just bullshitting. That's interesting.
What does this room tell you of the victim?
The portraits of actors from the past suggest that she was comfortable and happy in her profession. Judging by the flowers and perfume, I'd say that she was more liked than despised.
Maybe she could have put a hit on the other woman because she was got a part that she really wanted.
Watson, have you espied any new detail? Has a blinding revelation struck your brain?
I regret to admit, Holmes, that I am more confused now than when we arrived.
Well, that doesn't help, Watson.
Watson, do you have anything that might calm Miss Parker? We might as well have the benefit of her testimony, meager though Lestrade claims it to be.
Yes, Holmes. I'm carrying a potent sedative. A small dose should do the trick. Try giving her this.
A sedative? We're gonna drug her? And we're about to go drug her. At least he didn't just go up and just...
Thank you, sir. I feel better.
Hit her with a needle.
But much like I'm swimming underwater, I think I can answer your questions now, if my tongue will obey my brain.
Miss Parker, do you now think you might tell us what you saw of this terrible murder?
I saw Sarah lying there dead. Blood was everywhere, but especially by her head. I could see her. Her insides.
Ugh.
A man in a cloak was running off into the street, but I didn't get no good look at him. I didn't see no more than that, sir. Honest, I just ran in here and fainted, I guess. Next thing I know, Mr. Carruthers is waving his coat in my face.
Interesting. Baker.
Do you know any of her friends or relatives?
No, sir, not personally. I didn't even know Sarah very well. But about a week ago, Sarah got this pendant. Big, ugly thing it was, too. She said it was from her sister.
A pendant?
I believe her name was, like, Anna or Hannah, but I don't know where she lives.
This perfume was a gift, wasn't it? Do you know who gave it to her?
She said it was from a special friend, but I know nothing about him.
A special friend.
From time to time, but she was very secretive, always making sure everybody was away before she brought him up. As far as I know, he's the only man to see the inside of this room, other than Mr. Carruthers. I have no idea why she didn't want to show him off.
Okay, a secret lover. Oh no, don't go back to Watson. Before the sedative wears off.
What was your relationship to Miss Carraway?
All right, Busta, thanks.
We were performing the play The Loves of Hattie Hill, and Sarah was the lead. I played Beth, the servant girl, but I understudied the lead in case... Oh, I can't bear to think about it.
Oh, so she was the second. Yeah, she was the servant to the lead actress, see? And she was already studying the lead actress stuff.
Do you know anyone who could be responsible for this brutal attack?
So many things that could be happening.
I didn't know anybody on Earth could do such a thing as what was done to her. Now I know. There's monsters in the world for certain. But I can't believe they are friends of mine, or Sarah's for that matter.
Can you direct me to anyone who might help me learn more about Miss Carraway?
No, sir. I'm sorry. Like I said, I didn't know her very well. She was very protective of her personal life.
I don't know. She kind of hesitated there. Okay. We can go... Let's go back to the house. Or we can, we were already given the sister's address. Oh, here we talked to Caraway. Or Carruthers. Now, I'm assuming this is like the tech guy or the Mr. Fix-It.
What is the problem with that door, Mr. Carruthers? Which is to say, what are you doing?
Well, the plate is broken. I'm attempting to repair it. I'm afraid it's quite the army. I'll probably have to hire a locksmith to do the work.
Who forced this door?
Well, Inspector Lestrade thinks it was the Ripper. He says that the Ripper broke in here, dragged Sarah out into the alley to murder her. You think that's what happened, Mr. Holmes?
Well, that's not what we saw. Because in the very beginning, you see the lady, she walked out into the alley where the guy in a cloak who smoked. That's right, the guy, he took a smoke while he was waiting. He took a smoke, and when she walked out, he attacked her.
The inspector has many fine qualities, but he is overly fond of theatrics. It is clear that the murderer did not attack Miss Carraway here in this room.
What is your evidence for that, Mr. Holmes?
The flowers on the bureau.
These flowers came at least 2 days ago, Mr. Holmes. I received them at the front door and then delivered them up here myself.
The location of the woman's hat.
Exactly what I thought, Mr. Holmes. She wouldn't have had her hat unless she was going out the back door. That means the Ripper must have broken in during the performance and then went back outside to wait for her. Can't see that anything's missing, though.
So they're kind of saying that he broke in, couldn't find what he was looking for, and then just attacked her? And probably was looking through her purse, because her purse was also all jumbled up.
Do you know of anyone who might have harbored a grudge towards Miss Carraway? A rival or jilted lover? Or perhaps an obsessive admirer?
Certainly not. I can't imagine why anyone would want to arm her. She wasn't the greatest actress, but she was popular in a way and sweet. Well, now you mention it, who was the young fellow who was asking about her a short time back? He seemed rather suspicious.
Oh, okay.
What was suspicious about him?
Well, I found him hanging about in the alley. He asked if Sarah worked there. I offered to take a message, but he refused to leave his name or his reason for calling. Well, he was just a lad, no more than 17, bright-eyed, and very single-minded. He didn't want to see Sarah so much as he wanted her address.
A stalker.
Did you give it to him?
What you take me for, sir? I don't go handing me girls over to any dimwit who just happens by, thank you very much. My refusal didn't seem to bother him at all, though. He just smiled and thanked me for my time, pretty as you please. Then he said, if I changed my mind, he'd make it worth my while, and that I could leave a message for him at the Moon Gate, whatever that means.
The Moon Gate. Aha!
Have you recalled any details that might assist my investigation?
I think I told you everything I know.
Interesting.
Do you have the key to that chest of drawers?
No. My master key only opens the doors. Sarah is the only one who had the key to that chest. I think she had a spare, but I don't know where she kept it.
In her purse, maybe? Okay, now we're starting to shed some light on some stuff here. Who does the stain up here? Oh, what is this? The stain has the look and smell of a mascara hair oil. A macassar? I'm not sure what that word is. Macassar hair oil. There's splattering around the stain, indicative of a mild impact. A single black hair, 2 inches long, is caught in the oil. Can we take it? Can't take a sample of that? A single black hair. The door latch has been scratched and bent by what appears to have been a jimmy of poor quality. And the scratches are shiny, so it's likely that the door has been forced open within the past 24 hours. And these guys pick up on all kinds of small details. But I guess when you do this for a living, you know, makes sense. That carpet really helps bring the room together. Okay. Let's head out. Yeah, we already know that. So we're going to open the door. Let's get out of here.
I'm sorry, Mr. Holmes. The bolt is jammed in this lock. Until I can pry it loose to replace the spring mechanism, you won't be able to use this door.
What do you want me to go out the fucking window? Okay, what am I supposed to do now? Caught in the oil. Oh, let's see. Maybe I can inventory something. We'll just use the iron bar on the door. I can't do that. Okay, so maybe we're still missing something. And it probably is with this stain. Let's see if I can use an inventory item with this stain. Let's see. Pottery specimen. Oh, let's give him the spring. Maybe that's what's going to help with the door. So we'll give the spring.
I believe this spring may be helpful in repairing the lock.
Oh, yes. Thank you. I believe that's just the piece I need. I'll have this finished in just a moment if my fingers don't fail me.
There we go. Wow, okay. Alright, well, we'll see what Lestrade says, if he says anything different.
Is there anything more you can tell me, Inspector?
I have said all I have to say. I can only hope that my inquiries into the source of the murder weapon will reveal some new link that will lead me to this foul criminal and help me send him to the gallows. I hope you've seen something that I've overlooked, though I suspect the chance is remote. It appears I have little choice save to report to the Yard that Jack the Ripper is no longer satisfied with hunting in Whitechapel. A citywide alert must be posted.
Okay. And I don't think there's anything else I can interact with. The crates, I think only he does is, he just describes them. Oh, this is a well-traveled but sturdy crate with a detachable cover. The name of the theater stenciled on the cover is almost worn away. Footprints in the dirt nearby indicate someone standing here recently. Can I look at the footprints? No? All right, let's get out of here. It's an exit. Oh yeah, I wanna go to the exit. This cannot be open. There we go. Interesting. Okay. There's a whole lot of stuff that could be gathered from there. So we got, this is where we are in the alley. Baker Street, I think that's where we started. Yep, Sarah Carraway's flat. I like how it moves like that. Okay. I guess they just don't mind that I just go into somebody else's house. See what the bookshelf holds. A simple wooden shelf holds a half dozen assorted two-penny novels and the Holy Bible. The shelf area is messy. Books are open. Spines on one or two titles are broken. A mass-produced brass bed forged as a series of tubes for aesthetic reasons. The manufacturer has fitted the tops of the tubes with decorative hollow caps. They're convenient, though obviously hiding holes for small objects, and are sometimes known as the poor man's bank. Also, you can put like money and stuff in there. Oh, maybe I can open it up and see if there's something inside of it. I can. Look inside. A few coppers and a half crown are wedged into the left cap at the head of the bed. It's not possible to say with certainty whether these caps ever held anything else. Can I do the other one the same way? What else can I look at? Let's see. Looks like this picture's crooked. A cheap reproduction of Gainsborough's stunning portrait of the Duchess of Devonshire. Nicknamed the Stolen Duchess. Since the daring theft of the original form from a Bond St. Gallery in 1876. But it looks like it's something's wrong with it. Nothing of interest here. Like it's crooked, isn't it? Okay, let's see. No? Okay. Okay, fine. Let's see with the teapot. A serviceable, typical China teapot. 100 just like it are sold every day at Wapping. Dresser. A standard two-drawer dresser filled with cheap cotton underclothes, stockings, and jumpers. Mirror. Let's see what the mirror says. A tasteful cosmetic mirror which can swivel on its circular base like a gyroscope. Ooh, laundry basket. See if there's anything interesting there. A capacious, I'm not sure how you say that. Wicker basket of the type manufactured in Singapore and sold in nearly every street market in the metropolis. This one contains a conventional assortment of dirty laundry. Among the sheets, towels, and female garments is a man's orange-colored rugby sweater. Ooh. Cannot be picked, cannot be opened. Oh, wait, pick up. That's what I wanted to do. See what's up with that sweater. A man's rugby sweater with the colors and insignia of the Kensington Rugby Club. The back of the collar is heavily stained with mascara oil, and a few black hairs are embedded in the fibers of the wool. Okay, so that mascara oil and the hair is, I wonder if that matches what's on the doorway. Could this be the guy we're talking about? No, he's behind a chest. Yeah, he's behind his dresser. And there's a basket right here of clothes. Interesting. Okay. Yeah. It's a so my problem right now with when it comes to 3DO is that the best connection I can output with a 3DO is with S video. Like all my other stuff is RGB, a super clean RGB output. The 3DO, on the other hand, has only up to S video, and on top of that, so the games display in full natural 240 progressive, right? That's normal across all these old systems. But the 3DO actually, in the hardware, up-res everything the 480 interlace, 480i. And because of the 480i, in these new screens, everything gets kind of blurry. Because it's trying to take the interlace image and make it progressive. Oh, yeah. So, the color, that helps with the colors washing into each other, so maybe the colors aren't so similar, but because of that blurriness and the color, maybe it looks more similar than it really is. But that's something I need. There's another add-on piece I gotta buy that would help take care of that. I do not have that, nor have the money right now to get it, so we're stuck with a kind of slightly blurry image. Let's see, an umbrella. Let's see, this is an old and shapeless classic brawley, which has clearly survived a number of seasons. The blue muslin fabric is faded, and it is dry despite the wet weather outside. There's a slight bulge in the fabric near the tip. Ooh, okay. Let's open up the umbrella. Something falls.
A key. Amazing, Holmes. Only you could draw good luck from an action that's supposed to yield its opposite. Thank heaven you're not superstitious.
A key. A tiny brass key. It's too small for most door locks. It's most likely open something smaller, like a drawer or a jewelry box. Maybe that's the key for the dresser. Interesting. Barred door fire escape. The cross bar is sturdy and topped with enough coal dust to indicate that it has not been removed any time recently. So we don't have to worry about that. Maybe I can open it. Let me see. Cannot be open. All right, that's fine. So it looks like the only thing we need to worry about, or needed to worry about, was this key. This dresser we can already go through. The picture held nothing of interest. The brass caps had nothing of interest. The bookshelves. Let's see what Watson says. He gives us a different take on everything.
A rather humble room, Watson. What does it suggest to you?
It suggests that acting is not a lucrative profession, Holmes.
If you wanted to conceal something of value or importance in this room, Watson, where would you put it?
Well, if there's anything of import in this room, it is beyond my feeble powers to detect.
Do you believe Miss Carraway to have been an indifferent housekeeper?
It appears that house cleaning was not one of her strengths. Still, this appears to be more than casual messiness.
Excellent, Watson. What do you conclude from the condition of this room?
That the police made a dog's breakfast of searching through her effects.
Not necessarily, old friend. It is indeed clear that the room has been rather hastily searched. However, there is no indication by whom the search was done. Let us remember that there may be someone else investigating Miss Carraway's affairs.
A third party, probably.
Watson, has anything new occurred to you?
This room has much in it, but little of significance. Yet you often see where I am blind.
Okay. I guess Watson is more useful, like, if I'm not sure what to do, like maybe he would give me some insight. He did talk about he didn't find anything of interest or to hide something, so that I should be looking for it. And I end up finding that key anyway. With that, I'd say we go back to the theater and check that dresser that was locked. Check that dresser. Maybe this key will work in it.
Scotland Yard has been uncharacteristically efficient, Holmes. It appears that they have already moved the body to the morgue.
Oh, wow. It got cleaned up real quick. Okay. All right, let's go ahead and run the stream errors real quick, guys. And we will get back to the game. So let me know what you guys think of the game. It's pretty cool to me. Very interesting.
I'm enjoying it thus far. It's kind of cool.
Isn't it though? And I love the voice acting. I think it really adds to the atmosphere of the game.
And you said in the PC game, it didn't have voice acting.
I think that was when I read about the game, this game in particular, that the voice acting was brand new, but I'm not sure. Maybe the voice acting of all the lines is new.
Okay.
Or I'm not sure if they added the FMV or if the FMV was there for the PC also, but I'm pretty sure that's what I read. Yeah, Ronan, I agree. I think it adds it just adds to the atmosphere, all of it. And even the cartoon or like the regular sprites, the sprite animation work is also really good. Chud, congrats, bro, on your reward there for Stream Raiders. Appreciate the help. We're going to be doing a three skull now. Three skulls. I can't put the... I keep forgetting. It's healer. And rogue. I gotta put a rogue down. Let's go ahead and put that down. Rogue. There we go. London is beautiful, Paya. Oh, that's it. Must be parts of it, skunks. That's not all of it. I mean, you're gonna find that everywhere. Not every there's gonna be slums and bad parts, but you know, hey, we're not gonna use that as our central point. A mouse detective version of Holmes. Interesting. There's a ton of these games. I have a couple of them. If you here, give me a second. You'll only be able to see this on the camera, of course. But these are pretty cool that I found in my while hunting for games. I've been looking for PC games. And I found these two. This one's called Under a Killing Moon. It's in the original box, the big box and everything. Featuring the voice of James Earl Jones. It's supposed to be a pretty cool, like very, it's a detective game. Much more modern than this one is. So this one has like the actual voice actors, like the game itself is the voice. I mean, the actors themselves. Mufasa. Ooh, say it again. What's cool about this one, this comes in on a CD. I think that one comes out on a CD. And then I got this other one called Shadowcaster. But this is a first-person dungeon crawler. But this one comes in... You guys remember these? The floppy disks. 3.5 inch. The old school way. So I want to try to get me a computer where I can use those to install the game and play them. I've been obsessed with those kind of games. I do have also Myst. No, Myst, not Myst. Seventh Guest and the 11th Hour. The actual CDs of those for the PC. The originals. So I do have those. That's pretty cool. Chalk outline. Let's see what the chalk outline. Did they get all of her features and curves? A rough outline of the murder victim. Drawn in chalk by Scotland Yard. For reference in it, its investigation of the murder site. The body itself and any personal effects that have presumably been sent to the morgue. Oh, you got the special case, the 11th. Oh, nice. Very nice. You gotta take a picture. Put it up on my Discord. I like shit like that. We've already looked at that thing. Still got the blood stain next to it. Maybe Watson did it? Man, wouldn't that be a twist?
Why would Watson have done it?
There'd be no reason for it. I'm tired of you, Holmes. You're always taking over my glory.
I didn't realize this game was written by M. Night Shyamalan.
Yeah, there you go. Oh, can I not enter the door? Door's locked. I can't go back in. Interesting. Okay. They said it didn't work for doors, but I could try it anyway. Can't do that. Okay. Interesting. So everything's been locked up. Okay, so maybe I'm not supposed to be here. I gotta go back home. Come, Watson. Ooh, it's bigger. Oh, wow, there's more places. The map is bigger than it looks. Holy shit. There's a bunch of bubbles everywhere. Okay. Okay. What's this? South Kensington Field. Oh, that's where he found the shirt. The shirt was, guy's shirt was from that. The perfume place. And the morgue where they took the body. I don't think we need to check the body yet. Well, I didn't know how much of the map they were going to have. I mean, obviously it's a big city. I'm just saying, I didn't know how much of the map they were going to keep. Let's see what's up with this sweater. We'll start with that. There is a cool board game. I don't know if you've seen it, Phantom, where it's like Jack the Ripper. Like you got, there's four police officers trying to find Jack the Ripper.
Yeah, Letters from Whitechapel.
Is that what it's called?
Yep.
Yep. It looked really cool. One of the channels I watched on YouTube was playing it.
Yeah, I had it at one point, but I think I traded it for something. But yeah, no, Letters from Whitechapel, pretty cool game. Hidden movement game. Basically, you're like, we have four different cops and you're trying to chase down the player who's playing Jack the Ripper. Super fun game.
Yeah, where everyone's going to like take note. Where the Ripper's going to take note. He just writes down where his movement is. Whereas the cops got to kind of figure out where he's been moving, where he is, and it looked really cool.
Exactly, yeah. Super fun game.
Let's see.
Excuse me, young man.
I can't talk, you know. This all, won't you? There's a coach, go see him.
That guy's a winner.
What? It sounds like he took a soccer ball to the fucking mouth.
Either well, that or he's drunk.
Excuse me, princess.
All right, Paya. What seemed to be at first glance to be an enormous, anemic pig's bladder turns out to be a slightly deflated rugby ball. Okay. Oh, the water boy.
Jenkins, watch what you're about, man. Your tackling technique betrays no knowledge of the sport.
Though it's been years since I stepped onto a rugby pitch, Holmes, that group looks a sorry lot to me.
They're terrible. Apparently, they're terrible. You know what? Half the fun in this game is just hearing what the... or hearing and seeing the next actor they're going to use for each character.
Here, boy. Have you ever seen a young woman named Sarah Carraway watching the practices?
I don't think I've heard the name. But then my duties keep me very busy, and the players don't talk to me much.
I suppose the coach doesn't pay you very well for all your work. Here's an extra shilling for taking the time to talk to us.
I don't want no wages, Gov. I like helping the team. I'm going to be a three-quarter when I grow up.
He doesn't get paid? He doesn't want to get paid. Okay. A fashionable couple. A handsome young couple evaluates the talent of this year's crop of hopeful ruggers trying to make the Kensington Club. Let's talk to the coach. Not gonna like this.
What a talented group of muscular lads. The makings of a fine team, if I'm any judge.
If you knew anything about rugger, Gov, you'd know that size don't signify. Give me midgets with art and a knowledge of the game, and we'd hold our own. I've got over 30 shirkers scattered over this field with you pestering me. I'll never beat them into shape.
Okay, this guy's too intense.
Your current club appears to have excellent athletic skills. I suspect that your guidance will shape them up sharply into a good team.
Not with you hanging over my shoulder.
What?
I've got 15 blokes what don't know their left foot from their right.
What a talented group of muscular lads. And then the coach is like, give me midgets with a big heart and knowledge of the game, and I'll win. He just shat on everyone that's here. Look at, they're trying their best. Come on, coach. Don't be an asshole. Unlurk. I don't have an unlurk. But welcome back, Granny. I need
to speak with one of your players.
When they've left off practicing, you can speak with any of them for as long as you like. You want to watch? Stand with those people over there and stay out the way.
I'm sorry to interrupt, but I'm assisting the police in the investigation of a serious crime. I must speak with a member of your team.
Assisting, eh? I didn't know the coppers needed any assistance. You're meddling, more like. Now you stop meddling with me and my team. We've got work to do.
This guy.
This is Mr. Sherlock Holmes, the world's greatest consulting detective working with Inspector Lestrade of Scotland Yard.
Enough. I can see you'll not leave me alone till I've satisfied you. Name your man and I'll call him out.
I don't know the man's name.
Don't know his name? Off with you both. If you can give me a name, I'll deliver your man. But until then, stop wasting my time.
So we need a name. Okay, maybe we go back and look at the shirt. Maybe it'll give a, have a name on it. Look, coach. 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 Coach.
Do you know a woman by the name of Sarah Carraway?
Never heard the name. This investigation involves a female, does it? I might have known. Well, none of my boys can know aught about it then.
No women.
I still don't know the man's name, but I can describe him.
You're trying my patience, Mr. Holmes. Ask my boys what happens when I run out of patience. Give me a name and I'll help you. Otherwise, take off.
Take off. Wow, this coach is so intense. Granny, yeah, this is Sherlock Holmes. The Lost Files of Sherlock Holmes, it's called, on the 3DO, Panasonic 3DO. And Pi is right. This was released in 1994.
I still don't know the man's name, but I can describe him.
You're trying my patience, Mr. Holmes.
Okay, so this guy's not going to help me.
What happens when I run out of patience? Give me a name, and I'll help you. Otherwise, take off.
You know who he reminds me of? The coach? Like that portrait when he's talking to you, whatever? He reminds me of Soda Popinski. From Punch-Out. Alright. I didn't listen to the other stuff, but the numbers stuck. It was a good year, that's why.
I suppose the coach doesn't pay you very well for all your work. Here's an extra shilling for taking the time to talk to us.
I don't want no wages, Gov. I like helping the team. I'm going to be a three-quarter when I grow up.
Okay. Let's see if we can talk to this character, this dude. Maybe he...
Excuse me again, young man.
I said, listen! See the coach!
Wow, this dude is even more intense than the coach.
Excuse me again, young man.
I said, listen! See the coach!
Alright, Watson. What say you?
Do you know anything about this sport, Watson?
No, in my younger days, I had a modest success and a wonderful time playing with the Blackheath Football Club. It's difficult to tell whether or not these lads are enjoying themselves.
Do you see anything of import, Watson?
Not a thing, though my powers of detection are pathetically meager when compared to yours.
And Watson's so humble. All right, let's get out of here. I think I'm gonna run back to her apartment. and see if we can look for... Look at that sweater. Maybe we could find like a tag or something, a name on it. So we can get to that coach. Here goes the sweater. Alright, so we can't do anything with that. Can I pick it up? Nothing of interest here. Rugby sweater. The back of the collar is heavily stained in macassar oil, and a few black hairs are for fiber. But it won't let me do anything else with it. Let me see. He said he was a little bit busy. I guess work has him going crazy today. I can't do anything with that. Use, give, close, look 3D, pick up, open. Cannot be opened. Cannot be moved. Obviously can't talk to it. All right, maybe I can't do anything with it yet. Okay. Then we'll check out the perfume place. We'll do that instead. Because we can't get back into the theater. It's closed right now, so.
Good day, gentlemen. My name is Bell. If you require any assistance, please do not hesitate to ask.
Very nice. A cleaning girl. Let's see what she... I love seeing the actors. I'm telling you, it's the best.
I'm looking for a certain young man who purchased perfume from this shop recently.
Beg pardon, sir. My mistress don't permit me to converse with the clients. If she sees me talking to you, I'm sacked for certain.
Oh, wow. Okay. So we're going to keep talking to her.
Would you recommend a perfume for me?
Beg pardon, sir. My mistress don't permit me to converse with the clients. If she sees me talking to you, I'm sacked for certain.
Okay. Weird. Let's see about the chair. A comfortable and elegant straight-back chair intended for the languishing companion of the client currently being served by the dressmaker. Lilac gown. Next season's most extravagant entry in silk and organdi. I'm not sure if I'm saying that right. Virtually guaranteed to attract the newest crop of debutantes. As moths to a flame. Stairs. The perfumery also houses a dressmaking shop. These stairs lead to a fitting room intended for a select group of respectable ladies of certain age and station by appointment only. Excuse me? Two of the season's woolen winter clothes are on display. The fashion conscious may notice that the season's garments are not particularly distinguishable from last season's. I'm just putting the same shit up then. A variety of colognes. Wide variety of scents designed to confound the senses in the pursuit of love. I went cologne shopping once. With my with my ex. It's fucking impossible to figure out what the hell you want. The distinctive golden bottle of love promises much more than it can possibly deliver. Yeah, they always do. It is, however, prohibitively expensive, which makes up for any inadequacies in the product. Did it say expensive or inexpensive? This case contains many bottles of specialty. Specialty perfumes and accessories also serves as a point of sale. The placard reads "Eau de Seine." Oh, that's the same as the perfume that we have.
I'm looking for a young man who purchased some perfume from you recently.
I may be able to help you. What scent did he purchase?
Eau de Seine.
Eau de Seine, that's how you say it.
Ah, that is a very popular scent. Of the quality perfumes, it has the most modest price. What does this young man look like?
He wears heavy wool sweaters.
I don't recall a man of that description buying Eau de Seine recently. I'm sorry. I cannot help you.
Hmm. Maybe that's the wrong thing. Let's try this.
I'm still looking for a young man who purchased some perfume from you recently.
I'm afraid I don't recall a customer matching your description. If your description has changed for some reason, let me hear it again.
Oh, okay. He wears copious amounts of mascara oil in his hair, and he is in the habit of clipping his fingernails in public places. Well, we haven't seen that one, but we know the mascara oil.
He wears copious amounts of macassar oil in his
macassar.
Is he tall or short?
He's short, but the height of the counter, not that short. He's of medium height. He's taller than you. Than myself. I'm unsure of his height. Yeah, I don't think we've discussed his height.
I'm as yet unsure of his height.
I'm sorry, but your meager description is insufficient for me to assist you.
Damn, okay. How do I figure out how tall he is? And she's just gonna say she can't talk to anyone. How do I figure out how tall he is? Let me look at my inventory. Iron bar, cigarette butts, powdery substance. Okay. I don't have much to work with here without knowing more of his description. But he can't be that tall. Well, we know he's not as short as the... Let's see what she says.
I would like to purchase some perfume.
Very good, sir. Do you have a scent in mind?
I was hoping you would make a recommendation.
For you, sir, I recommend Poix de Vie. It is subtle and elegant, and any woman of sophistication would be most appreciative of the investment, if I may be so bold. Would you like to purchase a bottle?
Yes, please.
Very good, sir. That will be £2.03. Please come again.
So that's how you say, like, $2.03, whatever. £2, £3. Do I? Oh, and I have the other perfume also. Okay, okay. Let's see. Interesting. Okay. Let's go ahead and get out of here. I don't have enough of the description for the guy for her to give me any more information. Let's check out the morgue. See if they have anything more there we can talk about.
Good day, Mr. Holmes, Dr. Watson. You'd like to look at the body, I expect. I'll be with you in a moment. Please, look around if you wish.
That guy is uneasily happy. A tray of the medical examiner's tools, scalpels, clamps, needles, and sutures. I agree. Oh, there goes Sarah Caraway there. There's a body with his foot hanging out. Oh! That's gross! This unfortunate young woman bled to death from the deep stab wounds inflicted in her throat and upper chest. The fatal blade may have resembled the one reputed to be wielded by Jack the Ripper. So is it different from the one that happened to our girl? Jesus, another one with a right in the throat. The shallow but lethal incisions across this female's victim's throat appear to have been made with a surgeon's scalpel or a straight razor. How fucked is that, dude? Let's see what this Inspector Gregson says. We'll talk to British Lex Luger last. Lex Luger. Oh, Lex Luthor.
Hello, Inspector.
Yes, Holmes. What can I do for you?
Wait, that's a pretty big difference. It looks like the sprite has like orange hair with a mustache, but then he looks young as hell when you talk to him.
Hello, Inspector.
Yes, Holmes. What can I do for you?
Bye.
Has Miss Sarah Caraway's body arrived here yet?
Yes, I was just filling out some of the paperwork.
May I see the personal items that Inspector Lestrade sent with the body?
That's not standard procedure, Mr. Holmes. But I suppose there'd be no harm in showing them to you. Wait a moment, won't you? I'll retrieve them from the evidence cabinet in my office.
Yeah, I don't like him. He is 100% sus. Even concealed by a sheet, poor sir's body is in shambles. So a necklace, a handkerchief, a key, and a pendant? Let's run the stream ready real quick, guys. And then we'll continue on with the investigation.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't even know if we're winning. Oh. I think we're winning.
Come on, we got this.
We're so close. There we go. Very nice. I think we had a lot of extra healers and buff people instead of attackers. Who got the win? Skunk. Skunk, congrats on your rewards there. I'm gonna go with the question mark. Can I bring out another healer? Yep, I can do another healer. Speaking of healers. So that satisfies that quest item. Back to the game. So let's go ahead and see. Can we search Sarah's belongings? Let's see.
Have you learned anything more of the circumstances surrounding Miss Carraway's death?
Not really, Mr. Holmes. I did discover a trace quantity of a curious powdery substance on her coat. It doesn't look like cosmetic powder. My laboratory assistant won't be here till tomorrow, so it hasn't been analyzed. Would you like to see a sample of it?
Sure, but I think we already have a sample.
Indeed I would. Ah, yes. This looks to be just like the specimen I removed from the body at the murder scene. Perhaps I should analyze it at my lab.
Eggman!
Excellent. Perhaps you would be good enough to report your findings to me.
Of course, Doctor.
I don't know. That doctor, I don't know. I think that's the first real shady character that we've seen so far. Don't like him. No, wait. Can I go into this? Oh, okay. A handsome crimson handkerchief made of Japanese silk. Let's see what else. The pendant. The bracelet. A delicate gold chain. A delicate gold chain to which is attached to a semi-precious violet stone. It appears to be an amethyst and perhaps indicates that the victim was born between the 20th, January 20th, February 18th. What's January 20th to February 18th? What zodiac sign? A large iron key of the type usually associated with the locks of iron gates and sturdy external doors. A small, compact tin of Morley's something facial towel with a cotton wool applicator. Can I take any? I'm pretty sure I can't take any of this shit.
I'm sorry, Mr. Holmes, but I can't allow you to take anything without proper authorization.
Wow, Granny, why you slap Chud for?
Wow, so violent.
You just coming just angry.
Just slapping people.
With a chair, no less. Shit. Alright, so he won't let me take any of this stuff. I got a handkerchief, a bracelet. Oh, thank you. A bracelet, a key, bless you.
There you go, Chad, this is for you.
Are you stressed out over debt, unsure of what to do? I'm attorney Peter Francis Geraci.
There you go. Don't let it get away with it. Alright, I think we're done with this thing.
I need to run a few tests on these items whilst I have them here, Mr. Holmes. You are welcome to view them again whenever you like.
So, I think at this point then, we go back home and analyze.
What a remarkable odor, Watson. Some professional guidance, please. Can the stink of carbolic acid be harmful to one's health?
Not really, Holmes. This area must be disinfected regularly. Someone sloshes it everywhere several times a day. You'll become accustomed to the smell in a moment or two.
Sherlock Holmes is getting dizzy from the smell. A massive stone archway. A heavy masonry work supports the ceiling. Its covered arches, a dry and reasonably well-lit room, which nevertheless seems particularly damp. The architecture is reminiscent of the Roman catacombs. It does look like a fucking, like somewhere like in the bottom of the depths of Elden Ring. Aquarius. That's next, okay. Cause I'm a Capricorn, and my birthday's on January 19th, the very last day of Capricorn, which is very cool. What's also cool is my mom, her birthday is the very first day of a Capricorn. Pretty cool stuff. All right, let's head back to the pad. I'm next. I don't know how you spell it. Pisces? Oh, Pisces. Pisces is fish? Is it the fish? Actually, no. Let's see if this kid can tell us, do anything for us.
I require your assistance, Wiggins.
At your service, Mr. Holmes. Do you have a job for the irregulars?
Yes, Wiggins. Ooh. I have a certain flower I'd like you to trace for me.
Very good, sir. Let's have a look at it then.
So, inventory, he wants the flower. So let's give flower to Wiggins.
A blooming flower? What do you want me to do with it, Mr. Holmes?
You're the crab, what's it all? The crab is,
I need you to find the vendor who sells flowers like this.
Cancer, right?
A special flower, is it? Well, it looks a common enough bud to me. Flowers like this and is sold on just about every street in the city. If you please, Mr. Holmes, give me a bit more to go on.
Okay, so he needs more to go on besides just the flower. Maybe we can give him the perfume bottle?
I require your assistance, Wiggins.
At your service, Mr. Holmes. Do you have a job for the irregulars?
Yes, Wiggins. I have a certain flower I'd like you to trace for me.
Very good, sir. Let's have a look at it then.
Inventory. So I'm missing something with this flower? Give the flower to Wiggins. Her birthday is on Cinco de Mayo?
A blooming flower?
Cool.
What do you want me to do with it, Mr. Holmes?
Oh, nice. That'd be a real party.
I need you to find the vendor who sells flowers like this one.
A special flower, is it? Well, it looks a common enough bud to me. Flowers like this and is sold on just about every street in the city. If you please, Mr. Holmes, give me a bit more to go on.
Okay, so the flower is definitely a clue that he can work with, but we need We need to narrow the place down. The Better London Papers, several illustrated weeklies, a handful of the most scurrilous scandal sheets and magazines, and a small selection of chocolate confections are available at this stall. Unique among city newsstands. The proprietor keeps unsold daily papers for a week or so before sending them back to Fleet Street. Oh, okay, cool. I'm sure that'll come in useful.
Hello again, Mr. Rigby. Still well, I trust.
Can't complain, Mr. Holmes. And if I did, who would listen?
Too true. There's so little kindness in the world. Good day to you.
I like how you're not calling her Ashley or Ashley McGill, that you're calling her Ash Help.
That's how we know her.
That's tremendous to me. Does she know that? That'd be even better. She's such a good sport about it too. You know, obviously we don't mean anything bad or any, I'm not trying to put her out there or anything like that, obviously, but she's still being a very good sport about it, and I can appreciate that.
Did your study of this morning's newspaper provide anything that might be helpful to us, Watson?
There was nothing relevant in that scandalous rag, Holmes.
All right, so let's go ahead and use our powdery substance. No. Use powdery specimen on our chemical lab table. Ooh. A packet of Swan Vestas, the safety match of choice to HM the Queen's. A test tube. Does not give me a description. The oil wick burner. A simple but effective source of immediate heat for laboratory work is fueled by whale oil, which has been highly refined so that it burns at a high heat and does not smell fishy. HM, Her Majesty. Oh, gotcha. That's what HM stands for. Thank you, Chud. Silver nitrate. Zinc, nitric acid, sulfuric acid, hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid, calcium carbonate, sulfur. Am I supposed to do this myself? Adding sulfuric acid to the tube. Oh, that's cool. Look at the animation. Hidden machine. Room temperature is not sufficient for this test to react properly. All right, so we need to turn this on. Use No, don't do that. Stop that. Open? Cannot be open. How do I light this? Oh. Matches. Use. Damn it. H&M is also a close shop fire, according to Pokemon. Oh, okay. Baking soda and vinegar makes a volcano. Oh, I remember that. That was one of the experiments we did. Remember as like in high school or something? I remember doing something with that. How do I pick one up? Let's pick one up. Nothing of interest here. How do I do this? Cannot be opened. Use.
Oh God, yeah, you're trying to play with chemicals.
I think so. But it won't let me do anything. Oil wicker. See, I imagine I'm supposed to light that, right? But it won't let me light it. What am I doing wrong? And there's matches right here. Come on! Pick up. But it won't let me pick anything up. Cannot be open, close. That's not fair to do. It won't let me use the matches. Like, if I click on use, it brings up my inventory. Use the cigarette butt on it. No. So look, move, and talk. That's what I was thinking of, Chud, also. I don't have the matches. What I was thinking that I had to do is the matchbox is right there. Pick up a match in my inventory and then use it on the wick. But it won't let me. So I got help, the number of business cards, a powder, cigarette butts, iron bar, theater playbill, a flower, perfume bottle, brass key, and another perfume bottle. So I cannot, and I thought pick up, right? Pick up this. Maybe I am missing something else. Hold on, let me see what else I can do in the room. A candle's a good idea. There's a lamp. A book. Just chuck it all in the fireplace. Maybe there's something I can't do with that. Hold on. 221B is unfamiliar with the joys of curse and curses of central heating. For almost 10 months a year, a coal fire burns between 8 and 16 hours a day. During the winter months, no indoor life goes on far behind it. Wow. Yoshi, Chud? Yoshi. Chud is Yoshi? Watson's medical shelf, which needs a bouquet, a few pulp mysteries. Okay. It's a picture, a framed reproduction of Clifford's portrait of General Charles George Chinese Gordon. The hero of the Chinese War. I was killed by the Mandi's forces in the Battle of Khartoum. You are, Chud? And nothing wrong with that. Why, may I ask, did they call you, are you called? Yoshi. A common six-blade utility knife in the type used by Swiss infantrymen. Versatile in emergencies and dire straits, the primary blade of this one fixes unanswered correspondence and a few unwelcome bills to the wooden mantle like butterflies to a specimen box. Can I pick that up? No. Oh, here goes a chart. The periodic table of elements is affixed to the wall with the brass carpet tracks. Immediately below are hung measuring paraphernalia and a small ball peen hammer. Oh, his avatar is Yoshi. Got it. Is that your favorite character? A well-tended regulator clock, which keeps perfect time. The chimes that have been violently disengaged of the clock will not sound a quarter hour. Also, it doesn't make any sound. Probably just doesn't like all that shit. Love spreading the love. That's good stuff. This is a set of three hurling sticks using a mysterious Afghan game, which ride donkeys over a great distance in the purpose of capturing the stuffed head of an albino goat. I don't understand what I'm supposed to do now. So. Desk. Okay. Oh, I no longer have the powder. Oh yeah, here it goes. Use powder on the lab table. See, okay, so there's nothing in there. Inventory, I wanna see what, so we're gonna use the powder. But what he does is he picks up the sulfuric acid. Pops that in the tube, right? He does that himself. And then if I go back to my inventory and I use the powder, room temperature is not sufficient for this test to react properly, which makes me think I need to turn on that wick. That's what you'd figure, right? How do I turn on the wick? Even though there's a box of matches right next to me. So I figure I could pick up the matches. Nothing of interest. Open maybe the box of matches. Cannot be opened. Let's try closing it. Cannot be closed. Move. Cannot be moved. Let's talk to the matches. I want to use the matches, but all it does is it brings up my inventory instead. Oh my goodness, I'm not sure. It feels like this is what I'm supposed to do. I just don't know how to do it. Simple but effective. I don't understand. Give me a sign!
Ash, help! There's your sign.
Yeah. Dang it. Pick up. Nothing of interest. Nothing of interest. Yeah, I don't understand. I don't know what we need. Yeah, stop. Pixel League merch. What the fuck? Phantom, help.
I have no idea. I've never played this game.
Can we look it up?
All right, let me look.
Phantom, help. You have to help me. That was one of the quotes, right? Like, Phantom, you have to help me.
All right, what's this game called?
This is The Lost Files of Sherlock Holmes on 3DO. And I want to say, the case of the serrated blade or something like that. Because there's two major stories in it.
Alright, let's see.
I just want to know, how do I check the... Thank you. How do I check this pottery specimen?
Let's see. If you're at the part that I think you're at, use the powdery residue on the lab table and then use the residue on the flask?
Yes. I did that. He puts in, he puts in some sulfuric acid into the tube.
Okay, then use the oil wick burner and then use the residue on the test tube.
How do I use... That's the problem. How do I use the oil wick burner?
I have no idea.
That's the problem. Like, how do I use that? Oh, wait a
minute. Oh, look at that. What?
Excuse me? Why couldn't you do that before? You made me look like an idiot.
It's because I helped you. That's why.
A prop magnifying glass? That was easy. Yes, it was. I don't know why. I swear I couldn't do that before. Fire.
Alright, now that... Okay, and then you use the residue on the test tube. Now go outside and give the flower to Wiggins.
Let's get the residue. Let's see what happens. Ooh! I love the animation. It's so cool. Ooh, what's this? A black mirrored surface forms. What did it say? This indicates to something.
Let's see. After using the residue on the test tube,
or arsenic.
It says go up. Yeah.
Indication wow. Of arsenic. Ooh, the plot thickens. I can just leave, right?
Yep. Now go outside and give the flower to Wiggins.
Interesting. Arsenic, that it's deadly, isn't it? Like a poisonous thing?
Arsenic is deadly.
Yeah. And that was on her coat. All right, Wiggins. We're gonna do this again. This time, don't mouth back at me.
I require your assistance, Wiggins.
At your service, Mr. Holmes. Do you have a job for the irregulars?
Yes, Wiggins. I have a certain flower I'd like you to trace for me.
Very good, sir. Let's have a look at it, then.
The last time I tried to give him this flower, he just told me, like, that's pretty much sold everywhere. You gotta be a little more specific than that.
A blooming flower? What do you want me to do with it, Mr. Holmes?
I need you to find the vendor who sells flowers like this one.
A special flower, is it? Well, it looks a common enough bud to me. Flowers like this one is sold on just about every street in the city. If you please, Mr. Holmes, give me a bit more to go on.
Yeah, see, he gives the flower back. Because,
Yep. Yeah, that's all you're supposed to do. You're supposed to give it to him and tell him to find the person who made it.
No, yeah, he doesn't tell the person. He says where it was sold. That's what Sherlock is asking Wiggins. And Wiggins just gives us the flower back saying this could be sold anywhere in the city. He needs more information.
Okay. Yeah, all this walkthrough says is tell him to locate the person who sells it.
How? Maybe I gotta look at the flower? Let me see. Let's see if it gives me more information. A pink carnation with what? Dark veins.
Yes, just says, give him the flower and tell him to go find the person who sells it.
There must have been something else we did with the flower beforehand.
Maybe.
Ooh, the results. In addition to common soap, salt of tartar, and camphor.
You can do it!
Analysis reveals trace amounts of powdered, highly toxic arsenic. The combination suggests...
What?
I don't know. B-Cure's arsenic soap? A common preservative compound. Oh, maybe we take it back to the scientists or the coroner. Because that was on the body. We'll go do that first. We'll take this back to the body. Or, the corner. Where's my ex? Off we go. No cursing? Yeah, I don't know if we'll be doing much cursing on this one, Granny. We can redeem it later. We can give you back your points.
either that or your new curse word has to be Wiggins.
Oh, is that what it was?
I think so.
Oh, yeah. Wiggins.
Yeah, but I don't think you are going to do much cursing today, though.
No, I don't think so. This is not
intense
of a game.
Yeah, I'm giving those back.
Excuse me, princess.
Appreciate the redemption, Granny. But yeah, we could always do it next time. And if you want to keep it as Wiggins, even. That would be different from Clarf. Whatever.
Let's kick shell!
Oh, snap. Let's kick shell. We're gonna inventory. Let's give the arsenic to this evil looking bastard. Or maybe we just talk to him.
Pink fluffy unicorns dancing on rainbows. Pink fluffy unicorns dancing on rainbows. Pink fluffy unicorns.
Meow, it's what's up? Look at, we're trying to solve a murder, right? A really bad murder. The lady was slit open, guts all over the place. And you come in with pink fluffy unicorns. We're in the middle of a coroner's office. I do nothing. Yeah, whatever. Welcome in, Meow. Innocent as can be. There'll be hate on my choice of an act. No, I'm just messing with you, Spook.
I have analyzed the powder you found on the victim's body.
Excellent, Mr. Holmes. What were your findings?
My analysis showed it to be some form of arsenic compound mixed with soap.
That's a peculiar combination. I can tell you that arsenic had nothing to do with the cause of death.
Thank you, Doctor.
I don't know that doctor. No, Eggman is the murderer. Yeah, he looks too suspicious. Let's go ahead and run the stream raiders, guys. I just realized it was on. And then we'll get back to Eggman being the murderer. Sipping the key. Shit on a peacock. That's the murderer. I gotta find the actual full song of that. She's pretty keeper. Has a cool vibe sound to it. What's up, Meow? Anyway, welcome in. We're playing this game called Lost Files of Sherlock Holmes. It's on the 3DO. It's like a detective game, a point-and-click detective game. It's been really interesting so far. Why Paya? He got to get the blame for it. That's what happened. Solve the murder. It was a peacock. Hit her with such force, it ripped her apart. Granny, congrats on your rewards and stream raiders. All right, so I'll do, we'll do at least one more stream raiders, then we'll call it a day. I am having fun with this game though. God, was it an archer or a rogue I needed to put him? Let me double check. Rogue. Place three rogues. Yep, just this last one right now. Go ahead, pick up that reward because we already put the three things down. Let's get the rogues. Let's get us a rogue, put that down, and doing a battle plan and just vibe it, dude. Just no matter where you want to put your stuff. Let's just chill and have fun. Back to the game. Let's see. So we tell the coroner.
May I view Sarah's personal effects again?
They had nothing to do.
Mr. Holmes.
Oh, maybe we go back to her home. Maybe we'll find the soap. Made of Japanese silk. A delicate gold chain, which is attached to a... that tells her that she's, what do we say, Aquarius. A large key. She has the key to the... Oh, that's what the lady said. That she's the one that has the key to the door. Yeah, confusion. That's me. Ooh, can I...
I'm sorry, Mr. Holmes, but I can't allow you to take anything without proper authorization.
Ah, a facial powder. You think maybe that's what could be, what could have applied the, that powder, the that's killing us, that killed or that was on her. All right, let's go
I'm
check out
with these effects for now. Thank you.
Let's go check out her.
Very good, Mr. Holmes. You may
apartment.
View them again whenever you like. I won't send them over to the yard for a day or two.
See
you. Oh, it's you, Holmes.
Oh, here we go.
Inspector, could you authorize the release of some of the items from the Sarah Caraway case?
The Caraway case? Who's investigating that one, Holmes?
Inspector Lestrade was doing some of the preliminary work.
Oh, you mean the new Ripper case. Lestrade always gets the glamour assignments. I get what falls off his plate. I'm here on a simple suicide. Three witnesses saw this woman leap off London Bridge a week ago. Clearly a suicide. I'm just tying up the loose ends.
Huh.
Excuse me, Inspector. Concerning those Caraway items?
Oh, yeah. Sorry. I'm afraid I won't be able to help you, Mr. Holmes. Only Lestrade can release that evidence. I left him an hour ago at the yard. You might still find him there. I must warn you, though, that security procedures have tightened up some. Tell them I send you, and you should have no trouble.
Okay. At the yard. Okay. So that's our next destination. Very good. Very good. Very evil. Where's my exit? How do I get out of here? There we are. Okay. That applicator might have might do something about that case. Let's see, did it open? Oh, here goes the yard right here. I like turtles. Thank you. Thank you for your contribution.
Hello,
yeah.
Augie. In the pink and so on.
Oh, indeed, Mr. Holmes. Lovely spot of autumn weather we're having.
I'm doing good. Just been chilling, playing games. There's really not much else. It's been pretty relaxing. Everyone seems to be in pretty good spirits.
Hello, Augie. In the pink and so on.
How about
on.
You? We haven't heard from you in a while.
Indeed, Mr. Holmes. Lovely spot of autumn weather we're having.
And usually when you're streaming, it's like late at night. So I haven't been able to catch you on there. You miss game nights? Yeah, that I saw that Facebook post you put up. Me, you, and Chell. Our other sister. We're playing Talisman online. Or the Talisman game. That was fun.
Good day, Constable. I must speak with Inspector Lestrade.
Sorry, sir. What with all the recent troubles, we've had to restrict access to the building. Authorized personnel only, I'm afraid.
But this is Mr. Sherlock Holmes, the famous consulting detective.
That's nothing to me, sir. No exceptions. Please move on.
Wow.
Ah, yes. Inspector Gregson informed us of recent changes in security procedures. But I assure you, Constable, he has given us permission to enter.
That's as may be, sir, but I'll take my orders from Chief Inspector Palmer himself, and they are that no one is to pass without proper authorization. You understand, sir?
Wow, okay. Oh, atmosphere is so fun. Stop moving. Especially with that the actor. He makes it so much cooler. I thought they were making a new one, Phantom.
Not a new one. They're doing a 30th anniversary re-release. So it's the same game, reprinting.
Very nice. I have the original. I think it's still called Atmosphere, because I know I had a couple of different names, but I have the Atmosphere game.
There was two different games. There was one called Nightmare, and then they did a follow-up called Atmosphere. So two different games.
Maggots. Yeah, that's yeah. He was like, stop, maggots.
I banish you to the black hole.
I banish you. Oh, he was the best.
Yeah, I'm really glad they did a 30th anniversary re-release for that. Yeah, I still have all the original games too, all the expansions for it. Like, it's one of my favorites.
It's a cool interactive game. We just meow it till we come by the house and play with me, and like I said, my other sister also, and a friend or whatever, a couple friends, and we just like frantically moving our people around. Trying to get around and trying to get the stupid keys, and that's such a good game.
Good day, Constable. I must speak with Inspector Lestrade.
Sorry, sir. What with all the recent troubles, we've had to restrict access to the building. Authorized personnel only, I'm afraid.
But okay. This is Mr. Sherlock Holmes, the famous consulting detective.
That's nothing to me, sir. No exceptions. Please move on.
Ah, yes.
He's just following
Inspector
his orders.
Gregson informed us of recent changes in security procedures. But I assure you, Constable, he has given us permission to enter.
That's as may be, sir, but I'll take my orders from Chief Inspector Palmer himself. And they are that no one is to pass without proper authorization. You
authorization.
Sir?
I wish I talked like that. If you want to, Phantom, you can go ahead and run those, the Pixel League shoutouts. If you would so please.
Yep, coming to you.
What do I tell her? Well, you see, just be honest. I really don't think you should use that guy. He didn't seem healthy, he was all skin and bones.
What really happened? You don't mean he refused
Hello,
to help?
Hello, Augie. My compliments to you.
I see. I've
Very kind.
Abandoned.
Mr. Holmes, nice to hear from you and Dr. Watson.
Listen,
again. Is there perhaps something I can help
you? Got a proposal for you.
I need to speak to Inspector Lestrade.
Suck it,
the
dude.
The constable won't allow me access to the building.
No, I guess it is I who was sucking.
Real
oh, God.
Regulations the
I streamed something else later today. But I figured I'd pick this up and give it a shot. It was requested, so I'm definitely going to be doing it. Let's see. So the first 7 minutes of me reading have been completely erased because I forgot to switch scenes from the senpai order that I also have to manage to this one. That was my fault. I'm absent-minded like that sometimes. Sometimes I think it'd be easier just to record things and then re-upload them to YouTube instead of having to live stream.
My compliments. No, you don't, fucker. Oh, no, you don't.
Very
no, you didn't.
Mr. Holmes,
no, you didn't.
Nice to hear from you. And
oh,
Dr.
just like Mario
again.
Brothers. That's so
Is
cool.
There perhaps something I can help?
I need to speak to Inspector Lestrade, and the constable won't allow me access to the building.
Oh, sorry about it, Dragon.
Real sticklers nice. For the regulations the yard boys are, Mr.
But
Holmes.
Our princess is in another
Sorry,
castle.
I can't help you with that one.
Is that goofy looking guy?
Nice overalls.
Oh, so that's Sammy Lawrence.
Does it not seem to you, Watson, that English municipal architecture is one of the most depressing
what?
Art forms known to man?
That is Miss Empire.
Judging from this building, Holmes, I would say you have a case.
Mm-hmm. Shall we try to raise Lestrade, Watson?
Carry on, Holmes.
Do you think I'm fucking fragile? I've been through fucking shit. You can't fucking hurt me.
Shall
you
we try
really
to raise
can.
Lestrade, Watson?
Carry on, Holmes.
I've had years of trauma in my life. You can't do anything to me.
Does it not seem to you, Watson, that English municipal architecture is one of the most depressing art forms known to man?
Yay.
Judging from this
Whoa.
Building, Holmes, I would say you have a case.
That was cool.
So we can't go in. Alright.
Alright. Fun.
A rugby sweater. Yep, so that was the Pixel League. All of our friends in our community here that stream. Make sure give them a look-see. Show them some love. So we need... Okay, for the rugby player, we need the name in order to get a description from the coach. With that description, then I can go to the perfume seller and maybe she can give me some more information. But I need to start with a name on this shirt. How do I pull that up? Show the con insignia of the Kingston Rugby Club. The beak, the back of the collar is heavily stained with Macassar oil and a few black hairs. What's in the dresser? Stockings and jumpers, nothing. Pixel League assemble. Teapot. Is there anything in the teapot? Let's see, can I open it? Ooh! Okay. The color and the smell of the content suggest Darjeeling family of teas brewed in the last 24 hours. Okay. Put the sweater on and Watson just reads it. Sweet! Dude!
Dude, what does mine say?
Sweet! What does mine say?
Dude, what does mine say?
Sweet! What does mine say?
Dude, what about mine?
Sweet! I like how he gets more intense. Sweet! Like he's angry.
I haven't watched that movie in a minute.
That movie's so stupid. The picture. But the picture is crooked. So that makes me think I can move it. Door, mirror, rugby sweater, laundry basket, dresser, teapot, umbrella. barred door to the fire escape. Maybe I use the pipe on that. Fucking break it open. Oh god. Oh, I was about to say. I thought he was gonna do it. The crossbar is sturdy and topped with enough cold dust to indicate that it has not been removed any time recently. Oh, it just has the bar. We can just move it up. We don't need to break into it. Picture, brass caps. Let's check out that bookshelf again. Check out the mirror. Swivels. Oh. Check out the basket again. Maybe there's something else in the basket. Maybe we'll find more. Another sweater, maybe. My basket manufacturing in Singapore. We need a name. Maybe I'm thinking that this backwards then. Maybe I'm thinking of it backwards.
Watson, has anything new occurred to you?
This room has much in it, but little of significance. Yet you often see where I am blind.
So nothing's in it. Okay. So what can we do now? Let's see, the theater is still closed, if I remember correctly. Because we need the other detective. Yeah, we need his okay so we can get that key, which opens this door. And we have the small key. We have a small key for that other chest that was inside that place. Need something else I'm missing. Now we can't send that kid out that you said, Phantom, because we don't have a proper description of where he should be moving to. Maybe we just bullshitted our way through the describing the guy.
Hello again. If you need help deciding what you want, I would be most happy to assist you.
Wait, maybe there's a...
I would like to purchase some perfume.
Very good, sir. Do you have a scent in mind?
Maybe we could, with the Magasker or whatever.
Yes, I know the name.
And what is the name?
Oh, shit. Ooh, Flowers of the Orient. What was that one? Flowers of the Moor. La Côte d'Azur. I don't know. I got caught in a lie.
Flowers of the Orient.
That will be 15 shillings. Please come again.
Is that in my inventory now? Thank you, Swoop, for the fart. pink bottle named... Maybe I just get all the different ones? Collect them all. Like Pokemon. Alright, let's see if we can do this to get this young man's
I'm still looking for a young
description.
Man who purchased some perfume from you recently.
I'm afraid I don't recall a customer matching your description. If your description has changed for some reason, let me hear it again.
Okay. He wears heavy wool sweaters, copious amounts of macaskar oil in his hair. He's in the habit of clipping it. Okay, we know that oil in his hair.
He wears copious amounts of macassar oil in his hair.
Is he tall or short?
Okay, so... He's not short, medium, very tall, taller than myself. So we're gonna go... Flowers of the Orient, massive part. We'll go with medium height.
He is of medium height.
So are 90% of all the men in England. If you can't give me a more detailed description, I'm afraid I can't help you.
So it's gotta be tall then. We're just gonna run out our choices.
I'm still looking for a young man who purchased some perfume from you recently.
I'm afraid I don't recall a customer matching your description. If your description has changed for some reason, let me hear it again.
Okay, so we know it's the oil one, because she automatically stops with the sweater.
He wears copious amounts of macassar oil in his hair.
Is he tall or short?
He's got to be tall. Stop thinking that's why... That's why I had that, that same oil and the hair residue on the doorway.
He is very tall. Taller than myself.
Is he thin or stout?
He is fairly obese. He's thin as a rail. We're gonna go with thin. Tall and thin.
He is thin as a rail.
I don't recall a man of that description buying eau de Seine recently. I cannot help you.
That's not it then. Maybe he's a big guy.
I'm still looking for a young man who purchased some perfume from you recently.
I'm afraid I don't recall a customer matching your description. If your description has changed for some reason, let me hear it again.
Unless you were talking about the kid. But then they would say kid, right?
He wears copious amounts of macassar oil in his hair.
Is he tall or short?
Wait, he can't be that tall because he has the sweater. Because he's a rugby player.
He is very tall. Taller than myself.
Is he thin or stout?
Well, he's a rugby player, so he's got to be big.
He is fairly obese.
I don't recall a man of that description buying eau de Seine recently. I cannot help you.
So he's tall, fat, and greasy? Sounds like a biker from the 70s. Okay, that's not it. That's not it. Think. Okay.
I'm still looking for a young man who purchased some perfume from you.
Maybe it's a short one. The kid. Remember the guy said that some kid was walking around trying to get her address?
If your description has changed for some reason,
we'll go for short.
He wears copious amounts of macassar oil in his hair.
Is he tall or short?
I don't know how this lady is not, like, getting suspicious. Like, he keeps telling me the same shit over and over again.
He is rather short, about the height of this counter.
I don't recall the man of that description buying eau de Seine recently, or ever for that matter. I'm sorry, but I cannot help you.
So it's not short. Let's try the sweater
looking
thing.
For a young man who purchased some perfume from you recently.
It's gotta be the macassar oil.
I'm afraid I don't recall a customer.
I'm gonna keep doing this. Fuck it.
If your description has changed for some reason, let me hear it again.
This is the rest of the stream. Just me talking to the lady. He's in the habit of clipping his fingernails in public places. Can't be it.
He wears copious amounts of macassar oil in his hair.
Is he tall or short?
It's gotta be tall, because all the other ones stop you from answering.
He is very tall. Taller than myself.
Is he thin or stout?
So we did the two, big and thin.
I am yet as unsure of his build.
Can you tell me the color of his hair?
Ah, okay, okay. Black. The hair is black. We know that.
He has black hair.
I do recall a young man like the one you describe. He wore a striped jersey with a number on it.
There it goes.
I remember because when I remarked on it, he said he played rugby at a field near here. I'm afraid I don't recall the number.
What's his name? That's it? We can't go back into it?
I would like to purchase some perfume.
Very good, sir. Do you have a scent in mind?
Yes, I know the name.
And what is the name?
L'amour.
L'amour.
That will be 18 shillings. Please come again.
I think I'm just going to buy all the perfumes. So, she mentions the back. Oh, maybe this the cleaning girl. Maybe she knows something now. I'm going to get you fired, but at least, you know, you would have done something good.
I'm still looking for a certain young man who purchased perfume from the shop recently.
Beg pardon, sir. My mistress don't permit me to converse with the clients. If she sees me talking to you, I'm sacked for certain.
All right, fine. Fine. Be like that. Off we go, Watson. We are going to go back to the sweater. The sweater is the key to all of this. One red sweater. Why do you do nothing with the sweater? What's up, Dino? I don't think Night Trap is a sequel to this. But it is a full motion video game. I do have it. It's a fun game, I think so at least. Why do you do nothing with the sweater? Sweater is the key to everything. All you gotta do is pick it up and look at the back collar. Oh. Fucking Sherlock Holmes. But yeah, Dino, I'll play some Night Trap. It's a fun game. It's more like a game of, think of the whole game as like quick time events. Basically, I don't know where else I'm supposed to go. I just don't know. Or, have you ever played Dragon Slayer on the arcade, like where it's like a big cartoon, and you kind of just direct where you're supposed to go? It's closer to something like that. It is a weird game. You're not really... It's a weird game. Maybe I'll put it in for next week. So that's a good suggestion, Dino. Might put it in for next week, so... Part of next week's schedule. All right, we're going to go ahead and run this stream later, guys. This will be the last one of the day. This was a fun game. I really liked this game. Can I save it? I can. Gotta be this. This lady is the key to it all. Now she's just selling perfumes. Lilac gown. Yeah, this one's a really cool one. It's very intriguing. It's slow, but like, I think with the voice acting, it really adds to the game for something especially like a stream. Well, three winners: Baker, Phantom, and Skunk. Wow.
Of course, because it's the last one of the day, that's why.
Yeah, no kidding. Good job, guys. Thank you again for that help. So I've played another one on stream called Secret of Monkey Island, and it was on the Sega CD, but it had no voice acting, so everything had to be read. And I think that's would be harder to stream just because it's... Oh. Go ahead.
Well, you could always buy the special editions, which does have voice acting.
Secret of Monkey Island?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, yeah, but that was, like I said, I played the Sega CD version. I would have to buy the computer ones.
Yeah, they're actually coming out with a new one, Return to Monkey Island, this year.
Yeah, that looks cool. It looks good. I like the artwork. But anyway, for these old games, when they have voiceovers, even for like the RPGs, sometimes when it doesn't have voiceovers, I feel like it can get kind of dragged down with all the reading. In terms of streaming, you know, of keeping people's attention, so. That's just me, though. Alright, guys, I just saved. I think we're done with the game for now. I never found out what's up with the stupid sweater or that flower. Maybe we'll come back to it. I don't know. We'll figure it out. But I hope you guys enjoyed that. So, and enjoy the rest of your weekend. We do nothing this weekend. Tomorrow, of course, we'll do our movie watch along, which will be... What movie's next? I have it written down. Legend is tomorrow's movie. If you want to watch it together with us, same time as the stream, it'll be on my Discord, and we'll be watching Legend. It's an old flick. Very cool. I haven't seen it in forever. Very, very good movie, though. Yeah, and then, of course, Sunday I'll put up the post of what I'll be playing next week. Maybe I'll be continuing some of these games that I didn't get to finish from before. But, yeah, until then, thank you, Phantom, for hanging out.
Of course.
The entire time.
Always.
Thank you, everyone, for hanging out. Hope you enjoyed the game. And we will see you for the next stream. We'll be on Monday. Enjoy the rest of your weekend, guys.
Bye, everybody.
Peace. On to the credits.
The mimic that you were fighting is still dying.
Oh. Slowly dying. A terrible death.
By madness.
The hell did you do to that mimic?
Gave him madness.